Hey guys, how's it going? So the Pixel has become Google's new poster child, but you can't afford it and you still want that pure Android experience. Well, the only option you have is Google's last Nexus devices, one of which is a Nexus 5X. I reviewed this phone more than a year ago, but with the new year coming up, I wanted to see if this phone is still worth buying in 2017. Starting off with the hardware, the Nexus 5X is made entirely of polycarbonate material, which makes it really light in the hand and gives it a nice soft touch back. It's also pretty easy to hold because of its flat sides, and it's also not that big of a phone, so it's great for one-handed use. But this design also has some downsides as well, such as the definite creaking between the seams, and the camera protrudes a bit, but these things haven't really been an issue for me since I've been using a case this whole time. If I was making this video a year ago, I would say that this design is pretty stale. But with the recent barrage of premium metal phones, the Nexus 5X is ironically unique in terms of how it looks, especially with that Nexus logo. Also, this phone comes with NFC, a fingerprint sensor, which works really well, and a USB Type-C port with rapid charging, which I'll talk more about later. So with these things, I'd say that this phone is fairly future-proof because it can do Android Pay and has USB Type-C, which is becoming the standard for all phones. Oh, and there's a headphone jack, which is always appreciated. The screen is a 5.2-inch IPS LCD display with 1080p resolution. It doesn't have 2K resolution, but there's still high-end phones coming out with 1080p, so the Nexus 5X definitely holds up in that area. The display is really sharp, and although the colors might not be as vibrant as I would like them to be, it surprisingly does really well in sunlight. Additionally, the smaller display size is quite refreshing to see in an industry where 5.5 inches has become the standard. I feel that the 5.2 inch size is a perfect sweet spot for one-handed use and multimedia consumption. Speaking of which, playing videos, listening to music, and playing games is a pleasant experience because of the phone's front-facing speaker. It's by far not the loudest or the highest in terms of quality, but the fact that it's front-facing makes it really convenient for consuming media, especially when you hold the phone and your fingers don't block the speaker. But also keep in mind that only the bottom speaker is for playing multimedia, while the top speaker is only used for calls. Now on to software. The 5X currently has the latest and purest edition of Android 7.1.1 Nougat. There's a lot of nifty features here, such as image keyboard support, app shortcuts, and under the hood enhancements like significantly improved touch latency, which makes the phone feel much faster than it used to be. It's missing Pixel exclusive features like Google Assistant and the Pixel Launcher, but I haven't felt that I was missing anything as a Nexus owner. I made a whole video about everything there is to this version of Android on the 5X, so go check that out for a more in-depth look at this phone's current software. Aside from the cool features, the best part about having a Nexus phone is that you get regular updates straight from Google without carrier intervention. I've been getting monthly security updates since the phone's release, and Google guarantees updates until September 2017. That might not sound like a long time, but according to the trends of older Nexus phones, Google continued to push out security updates for another year after their end-of-life dates. So you're gonna get at least another year of updates, which is actually better than a lot of phones coming out now. Other than the dedicated software support, my favorite part of this phone is its 12.3 megapixel rear-facing camera with a f2.0 aperture and dual LED flash. This camera does a fantastic job in almost every situation, even in low light. Although there's some missing features like 60fps video recording and other typical phone camera issues like lighting changes, photos and videos are almost always really sharp, vibrant, and just high quality overall. I'd say this camera still competes with 2016's flagships like the Galaxy S7 and the iPhone 7. So you really won't be disappointed with this camera. In terms of the phone's actual performance, it's a mixed bag. It's got a Snapdragon 808 processor with 2GB of RAM and 16 or 32GB of internal storage. Having unskinned Android does make it a smooth experience in terms of fluidity and animations. However, it's not the fastest in terms of speed. It's pretty fast majority of the time, but there are occasional times where it slows down. I also feel that the Snapdragon 808 falls behind in terms of gaming. Your casual simple games will play perfectly, but when playing a lot of 3D games, I often had to lower the graphical settings significantly. The biggest problem is the low 2GB of RAM. It gets really annoying when I switch to a recent app and constantly finding that it has to be reloaded because the low RAM didn't keep it running in the background. Another issue is the Wi-Fi connection, which is pretty spotty. Certain connections are totally fine, but the phone has a really hard time staying connected to public Wi-Fi like my school or Starbucks. but I do think it's definitely been improved since the last update. Overall, I'll say that if you're not a heavy user and you only use your phone for simple tasks like social networking and browsing, this phone performs quite well in that perspective. Let's move on to the worst part about this phone, which is the battery life. It's got a 2700 mAh battery, which doesn't sound too bad considering a smaller display and the Google Pixel, which has about the same milliamp hours. But this phone really struggles to get through the full day, even for non-heavy users. I get around 2 to 3 hours of on-screen time per day, and 3.5 hours at best. The USB Type-C rapid charging feature does offset the horrible battery life, because the phone does charge really fast. I get from 0 to 100% in about an hour and 45 minutes, which is pretty good, even compared to recent high-end phones. But yeah, if battery life is a huge buying factor, this phone isn't gonna cut it. So, all of what I said about this phone sounds pretty decent so far, but there's a very important issue that I want to talk about, which is the boot loops. Boot loops are when your phone randomly reboots and eventually makes your phone ineffective. LG has a history with all their phones encountering boot loops after a year of usage, and I personally ran into that problem with my G4. LG and Google have both acknowledged that the Nexus 5X has a hardware design issue that makes it run into boot loops, so software updates or not, this phone will most likely face the problem down the line. There's still a chance that you might not run into this issue, but really, you need to be one of the lucky ones. So in conclusion, is the Nexus 5X still worth buying in 2017? If you're already an owner of the Nexus 5X like me, feel free to love it, because I also really enjoy using this phone. But its terrible battery life and the unavoidable boot loop problem makes it really hard to recommend its purchase to anybody in 2017. Especially today, where inexpensive $300 to $400 phones are getting so good. But if you're willing to look past all the problems that I've stated and still want to buy this phone, here's a couple tips. Don't buy the 16GB version, don't buy it used, and buy it new from Google for better customer service than LG, because once you run into that boot loop, you're going to need a quick replacement, which Google can provide much better and faster than LG. So that's it for the video, and if you guys like this, please click that thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel for more tech videos like this. See you guys on the next video. Bye.